the respective dignitaries on the dais, and colleagues and friends. I thank you all for coming to share our happiness during this 50th anniversary year of NARI. We don't have many ceremonies because the work ethic in this place is so strong that having a day off work is frowned upon. And going on holidays is sort of out of the question. After I started working at the Animal Husbandry Division, I had to convince my father that holidays taken by staff are actually good for the institute because they come back refreshed and work much better. So I would like to thank Dr. Rajvanshi and Dr. Nandini Nimbkar for organizing this rare function and doing all the hard work associated with the planning and implementation, and for giving time to the four new engineers to complete the different tasks such as the souvenir, the video, the exhibition and many other related things. I always expected that. As I look back upon the last 28 years that I have spent here, I realize what a debt of gratitude I owe my father for his vision for establishing this institute, where I could find my calling in life and shape my career, and in the process improve the lot of a large number of goat and sheep rearers. We also owe a great debt of gratitude to my grandfather, Vishnu Ramchandra Nimbkar, because it is his wealth that he earned with his hard work that gave us the freedom to pursue our intellectual goals while bringing about scientific and social development in our chosen fields. Of course, to bring my father's, all of his ideas to fruition, what is required is an army of researchers and infinite funding and infrastructure. I have had to curb his enthusiasm in recent years, especially after his so-called retirement, and tell him that I now need to pursue my own research direction and my responsibilities to the international bodies that I sit on. My parents now have the rare privilege of having all three children and two grandchildren living in the same town as them. But we have taken after them and got so busy in our own pursuits that we can't necessarily spend much time with them. But apart from our genes, the credit for what we are goes more to my mother, since she was the one who brought us up. My father used to be busy and away from home a lot of the time. I'm tempted here to relate the story of the newspaper report that was published in one of the local newspapers when I was in primary school that had the headline, "Rich Farmer Entrepreneur's Wife Steals Beggar Woman's Son." And after this, one of my classmates, who was a boy, of course, wrote a letter to my mother and asked her that he was offering himself in adoption to her. So the man who was universally pitied for having three daughters is now perhaps envied, because a lot of children these days don't live near their parents and migrate to faraway places. There was never any doubt in my mind that I wanted to live and work in India. After the unfortunate breakup of my first marriage, when I met my second husband, Gavin Bromelow, in 1987, and we realized that we were strongly attracted to each other, I told him I would never migrate to Australia. And he told me the same thing about India. So we decided to see how our relationship would stand the test of time, and it is still going strong. He was here for 1.5 months over January and February and just went back to Australia. His abiding love and support have been crucial to me. He has also helped NARI in importing boar goat embryos and in many other activities. As Anil mentioned, after I started working here, the major problem we found was finding good people. We started hiring veterinarians for our first project and ran through about 20 in the first 3 years. There was the attraction of government and bank jobs and urban areas. We then learned that we would be much better off hiring local people and training them, even if they were less qualified. We decided at one point that the willingness and ability to learn would be the most important criterion for hiring a new staff member. And we still have that criteria. I would also like to mention that we have also had a lot of staff members who have been with us almost since the setting up of the Animal Husbandry Division, and they are here, most of them in this room. And it is because of them that we have been able to carry out all the work. They are now the mainstays of the Animal Husbandry Division. One day I happened to answer the phone in our office, and the caller wanted some information on our programs. I tried my best, but in a few seconds he asked to talk to Bharati Pawar, who is now the assistant director of the Animal Husbandry Division. But that is excellent because it frees me up to do the things necessary for the division that only I can do. Obtaining enough funds to run the Animal Husbandry Division has always been a worry, because project funding many times does not pay salaries, and project funding is even inadequate to carry out the project, necessitating our putting in our own funds into the project. And I remember the sleepless nights I used to spend about the low salaries we were paying our staff members. But fortunately, the NARI Suvarna breed that we developed was taken up strongly in Karnataka, and we could start paying at least halfway decent salaries. However, now we are not able to sell the breeding animals at the high prices we could get earlier, so money has again become a matter of concern, because we also need to revamp our frozen semen laboratory and buy a lot of new equipment, which costs a lot of money. But then the struggle never stops, does it? Animal husbandry has also been a challenging field to work in. It has tremendous potential for growth and development of the rural areas and for improving farmers' incomes. But it has never been given the importance it deserves, even in a largely agrarian country like India. If it were to get dynamic and inspired leadership, such as, for example, the former Animal Husbandry Minister of Karnataka, Mr. T.B. Jayachandra, or one of the former secretaries of the Animal Husbandry Department in Maharashtra, Mr. Rajesh Agarwal, it would definitely lead to a substantial increase in the low growth rate of agriculture that we have right now. But unfortunately, good people don't stay in animal husbandry. They are either transferred or they ask for a transfer, possibly because there's not much glamour associated with animal husbandry. And dealing with the people who are then left in animal husbandry is challenging, to say the least. And in recent times, of course, people with a very narrow worldview have also thwarted the scientific development of the animal husbandry sector. NARI now has not only its own work to be proud of, but also the work of the Pragat Shikshan Samstha that Dr. Maxime Bernson set up and that Manju is now running. And my father donated through NARI the structures of the godowns and the seed processing plant in Phaltan town to them in the 1980s. And Pragat Shikshan Samstha has now established new standards for high quality innovative and enjoyable education in Marathi medium and is now spreading these ideas in 150 Zilla Parishad schools in Phaltan Taluka. For a strong democracy, it is necessary to have a strong network of capable independent institutions such as NARI. However, the trend in recent years seems to be to undermine such institutions and even persecute some of them. So I hope that the government will come to realize that there are benefits of strengthening such institutions. For the future, we have a dire need for new blood in the organization, and not just people who come for a job, but dedicated people who would be willing to take over and continue the work. Now is the time when we should be grooming the new directors and president. And so if anyone has any ideas for the future of the institute, do tell us about them. Finally, I would like to invite everyone after lunch to the Animal Husbandry Division to see some NARI Suvarna sheep and their lambs and boar goats and some of the other animals. And also the small memorial that we have made to my great-grandfather, because he used to live on Wadzan Farm, where the Animal Husbandry Division is now located. I would like to thank all of you again for your support.